give you a better understanding of these amazing animals and all that they represent.
In every ocean, orcas living off the coast of Iceland are quite different than those near Costa Rica. In fact, there are at least 10 types or ecotypes of killer whales. An ecotype describes the differences between killer whale size, physical form, prey, social structure, and habitat. As you can see, the differences are subtle, but noticeable when compared side by side. Orcas are adapted perfectly to their environments. And even the whale's black and white coloration has a purpose. It camouflages the outline of their bodies in the water, making it easier for them to surprise and catch their prey. When viewed from above, the black of the whale blends in with the dark depths of the ocean. When viewed from below, the orca's white bellies match the brighter surface of the water, blending with the light above, giving them the perfect camouflage. She is in charge. It's all about attitude, not size. Because they live and work as a group, Orcas need to communicate with sounds and body language. Orcas use clicks for echolocation or navigation. Whistles to socialize in the pod. And calls for group coordination and hunting. Vocal development studies here at SeaWorld show that early on, calves learn vocalization from their mothers. But as they grow, they learn from others close to them as well. This is a bottlenose dolphin call that Shuka learned and even taught other killer whales here at SeaWorld. In fact, orcas are the largest members of the dolphin family. Whales here and in the wild use vocalization to communicate all the time.
Like all animals, killer whales use body language as part of their communication. Pectoral flaps are used to show dominance or to get noticed. For example, a mother might use a pec flap to get her calf attention. But when they really want to be heard, they breathe.
Together to rear their young, protect their pod, and most importantly, pursue and catch their prey. Every day they cooperate to survive in the wild oceans of the world. The orca's hunting techniques are as varied as the whales themselves. Norwegian killer whales will circle herring, herding them together. The whales use sounds to coordinate with each other and to disorient the herring. With the fish confused and contained, the whales stun them with their powerful tail flukes, making for an easy meal.
Create waves that wash over floating seals into the water. Watch as Shuka demonstrates his wave-making technique, showing off one of the many complex and impressive hunting abilities killer whales have developed all around the world. The amount of water displaced until you experience it for yourself. Luckily, we have two very brave volunteers who are going to feel the power of the killer whale tail blinks in that 55 degree salt water. Alright. Guys, look ready. And I think the whale's ready. So we're going to have Kalia and Shuka give you a very special way of saying hello. Here they come. All types of prey, including other whales. Oh! On the screen behind me, you'll see the blue whale. It is the largest animal on Earth. It is 5 times longer and 50 times heavier than the killer whale. So how did the killer whale this size prey on a whale that size out in the wild? Well, it's all because killer whales are the ultimate team players.
In this example, we see the larger male orcas surround a sperm whale, forming a perimeter, while the females continue to drive the whale forward until it reaches exhaustion. The calves then move in to join the adults in the group. Whatever their prey, killer whales always cooperate and hunt together, making them a highly successful predator.
Play is an important part of everyday life for a killer whale. It's how they teach their young to hunt and practice those skills as they grow. Killer whales are often seen interacting and showing off their playful side, both out in the wild and right here at SeaWorld. Porpoising is when a killer whale swims fast at the surface, breaking out of the water briefly. behavior has a purpose. In hunting, a tail whip is used to stun fish. But today, I think our whales might just be stunning all of you. And the adult whales are maintaining a healthy weight. We can even obtain a breath sample from their blow hole. All these behaviors are possible because of the trusted relationships we have built day after day right here at SeaWorld. Now, I'd like to introduce you to a very special whale. Coming in front of you is Kalia. Kalia is 17 years old and loves hanging out with her brother Makani and loves big snowballs and ice treats. Kalia has participated in many research projects to help her whale counterparts and has inspired millions throughout the years. Now we challenge our whales every day to learn new things to stimulate and engage their minds. Diet, exercise, and of course play. I'll help keep our whales in great shape.
The whales here at SeaWorld have helped killer whales in the wild by participating in many research studies. One ongoing study monitors the whales' heart rate and breathing to understand how marine noise pollution from ship engines and other sources affect wild populations. In another study, scientists from NOAA, the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, took measurements of the killer whales living here, including pregnant whales. By comparing these measurements with drone footage of killer whales in the wild, scientists are able to monitor the wild population's nutrition and reproductive skills. Other research has been done here at SeaWorld on the mother whale's milk composition. This research will help create an effective model to understand how toxins in the ocean impact wild killer whales and their milk supply. What we learn from the whales in our care every day is actively helping whales in the wild survive. And just by being here today, you've supported our rescue, research, and conservation efforts all around the world. If we work together, like the killer whale, we can protect the future of the Orcinus orca and this beautiful planet that we all share.
Thank you.
person. Have a great rest of your day.